Darth Vader saying to Luke Skywalker for the first time, "I am your father," was an iconic and impactful moment, not only for that movie, but overall in cinematic history.
I am your father.
But imagine those who watched that scene after having watched the Star Wars prequel trilogy. It certainly wouldn't have had the impact it was supposed to have, would it? You agree, don't you? This "I am your father" line has been used quite often in movies and shows, and all the suspense in revealing someone's unlikely parentage is now gone. Same is the case when we discover the father of the protagonist of this Netflix show. Hello, namaskar, welcome, swagatam. Netflix has now adapted Thomas Wheeler and Frank Millar's novel Cursed into a series. The 10-episode first season has aired, and I am here to share my thoughts about it. To be clear, I haven't read the novel, so no comments on the source material. The premise is simple. This is a retelling of the legend of King Arthur and his magic sword Excalibur.
The legend says, this sword belongs to the one true king. But what if the sword chooses a queen?
So there are characters like King Uther Pendragon, Merlin the Magician, legendary knights like Lancelot, and the old practice of witch hunt and so on featured in this series. The story of Arthur, Merlin, Excalibur and Nimue. This is a legend we have seen told in so many forms, so many times.
Merlin, Arthur needs you!
Merlin, I fought a war.
Before Arthur became king, he was a soldier.
It is inevitable.
He felt it. The power.
His name?
Merlin. Who do you think you are, the king?
No, I'm his son. Arthur.
Nimue, never have I seen a creature quite like you.
Nimue.
One might ask, did we really need another story revolving around these characters? But I digress. Back to the series Cursed. In this series, Nimue is a fae, a species of several different varieties of humanoid creatures, some with supernatural abilities, but mostly just living creatures who happen to look different than humans.
Because we're different. Because magic runs through us. Because we have what they want.
So obviously, the story attempts to address the burning social issue of racial discrimination with an analogy of the fae. But really, the story is not serious or deep enough to be a reflection of the grim reality. It is just best to consider it a fantasy. Nimue is given this sword of power, and although she does have some capabilities and supernatural abilities of her own, she hasn't proven herself worthy of such an honor and responsibility. She hasn't earned the sword, so to speak. So the phrase "I did not want this life" is repeated over and over again in tones which some of us might consider whining. Anyway, that being said, the first season of Cursed shows Nimue's journey from being an outcast but ordinary girl to a savior of a race. In a sense, it is a coming of age story. In more specific terms, it falls in a kind of young adult fantasy genre. Nowhere near the grim vibe of The Witcher or the political intrigue of Game of Thrones or the rich fantasy world of The Lord of the Rings.
Hold that sword and leave.
Lead them where? To more slaughter?
You are not some fragile maid. You are a warrior.
When Nimue accepts her destiny and tries to become the savior of her people, there is no palpable change in her personality. Just a continuation of the same, uncertain of her powers, unsure of her past, and confused of her emotions. Nimue has been under the influence of the sword for some time, making decisions which she otherwise would never have taken, but she never displays a level of maturity or conversion or growth that I expected to see from someone who literally holds the fate of hundreds in her hands. Obviously, Nimue is young and her indecision, her doubts and her infatuations are understandable. But the point is, these traits don't make her a compelling hero, just another teenager. Which brings me back to my original point. This is more in the young adult arena. You see, I tried my best to understand what makes a series great or movie. I mean, as a viewer and a YouTube reviewer, it is very easy to make fun or complain about the material which several hundred people have worked on tirelessly for months. Liking or disliking is surely subjective, but there is certainly some factor which makes a series like The Witcher feel like I could binge it a few times, while in other cases it might be a hard enough job to just endure once. If I summarize all this in one word, the one factor that is needed to break the threshold of mediocrity, it is intensity. Intensity of action, excitement, drama, visual storytelling, and most of all, intensity of emotions. You know, the internal conflict, the weight of each decision that the protagonist takes, the story which conveys these things reaches deep within the audience and rises high among the pile of so-called normal storytelling. Don't get me wrong, Cursed is not a bad show by any means. It is just not fantastic. The most important problem with Cursed, the series, is the excess of subplots and characters. There is Nimue, the protagonist, the sword is the major plot device, and the evil villain, Father Cardin, who wants to kill Nimue and own the sword.
Our mission is the extinction of magic.
Okay, then there is the king, King Uther, who wants the sword. Uther's mother is a confusing character. I mean, why does she keep making what seems like poisoned deserts? Merlin has a past, which doesn't make it clear whether he wanted to live or die. Then there is Nimue's love interest, Arthur. At times, he seems noble. Then he is stealing stuff that doesn't belong to him. After the initial three episodes, he has a complete good guy type story, which begs the question, why was he introduced as a dubious character in the company of loudmouthed, cheating mercenaries? All in all, the writers attempted to give Arthur a hell of a backstory, strife with childhood loss and trauma and tragedy, but things didn't actually add up. Then there is Arthur's sister, who is a strong and vocal supporter of the Fey rites, but then she gets infected by a spider and becomes another confused contender for the ownership of the sword. The powers that Nimue exhibits, it is never clear whether they originate from the sword or from her innate connection to the supernatural forces that the Fae worship as the hidden. There is a flashback scene which perhaps would have been better served as a monologue instead of a weird supernatural time traveling like Bran and the Three-Eyed Raven. There are several parallels of the historic characters and practices of medieval Britain in this series, the most prominent of which is the church's continuous struggle to hold sway over the ruling king of England. So there is the complete hierarchy of the Pope, his disciples, monks, bishops and priests, but all those just blend in with the overall story without lending it any additional zing of authenticity. Because obviously this is not a historic series, this is a fantasy. I was particularly disappointed by the season finale, which actually was visually good, but not a seamless convergence that all the preceding events might be leading to. There is no happy ending, okay? Characters are put in place for the next chapter of the story, I mean the next season. The evil villain dies, the sword Excalibur finds an owner, some characters change their allegiances, and Nimue is left to an uncertain fate which might bring her closer to the legend of the Lady of the Lake. I will watch the second season with mild hopes and expectations of maturity. But as it stands, this first season of Cursed will only get 5 thumbs ups out of 10. What do you think? Do let me know if you agree with my thoughts, if you have watched this season. If not, well, better go and binge The Witcher. As always, I'm eagerly waiting for your comments and feedback. If you like this review, please do share it with all your friends and do subscribe to my channel, The Versatile Doctor, to stay tuned with me. Clicking this bell icon will notify you of all my uploads instantaneously. Till the next video, this is Dr. Abhinav Atul signing off. It is my pride and privilege to be able to connect with you through this video. Namaskar.